Welcome back to Tea Time. We're talking about stress. So, get your kettle. I forgot what you used to make tea there for a sec. Get your kettle on, sit down, relax, and get ready to learn. Cheers. Cheers. I'm not worthy.
Do my piece.
Do your piece.
Hi, it's Claire from the 3 T's, mental health coordinator and psychotherapist.
So this is Chloe. She can't help being adorable and relieving stress anyway. Yeah.
There's a lot of research that goes to say that having a pet and walking a pet, cuddling a pet, just being around an animal can be really good for your stress levels. So that's why we brought Chloe here today.
Really bad for my attention span. Like it's I'm not paying attention here at all because I'm so distracted. But this is actually really important. So stop looking at the dog and pay attention. What are we talking about? A lot of us feel stress. Claire, I find that it's like my petrol sometimes, like that it really keeps me going. There are points it becomes a little too much.
Yeah.
Does that change for every person? What is that?
Everybody's ability to deal with stress is different, yes. Yeah. But there are actually two types of stress and it's really important to talk about them. So the first one is good stress or eustress. And it's that stress that you're talking about, the one that helps motivate you, helps us seek out change and helps us deal with that feeling of stress. It's also the stress that occurs when we're going to the airport and we're worried about forgetting our passport and our ticket. Did we pack enough bikinis? Have we brought our toothbrush?
Chloe's felt that. Chloe needs like 8 bikini tops and 1 bottom, so she finds it really hard to shop for them.
That's one type of stress, but of course you realise once you get to the airport, of course you've got your ticket and your passport and you can just buy a toothbrush when you get to the other side. So that's good stress. It's short term, it's short lived, and there's a very obvious cause.
And it's completely justified. Forgetting your toothbrush makes you feel gross.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
But then you've got bad stress or distress. So that's the one that people tend to talk about a little bit more. So that's when you're afraid of losing your job or losing your house, or there's difficulties in your relationship,
right,
or you've got money worries. They're much more long term. There isn't a clear cut solution.
Okay.
And that's the stress generally people talk about a lot more. But stress is really beneficial, as you said, because it does help motivate us.
We see in media and in cartoons like a person twitching their eye or like a vein pulsing. But it's not always that, is it?
No, it's not always really obvious signs like that. So sometimes it can be things like pains in your stomach, not being able to fall asleep as easily as before, withdrawing into yourself. Sometimes you would even stop looking after yourself. You may stop showering, you might wear the same clothes over and over again. And you're kind of getting into the territory of burnout there, where your demands are completely exceeding your coping skills. So there's a total lack of balance in your life.
It's okay though to use some of those symptoms almost as preventative measures though, right? So like having a day where you maybe don't get out of bed and maybe don't shower. Like, give your hair a break. That's a great excuse. I use way too often.
Yeah, you're not giving into it all the time by maybe taking a day for yourself and de-stressing. In fact, that's one of the coping skills that I would often use with people. Take a day, have some fun, either stay in the house and chill out, maybe with the dog, or maybe bring the dog for a walk, go out and see your friends. But fun really helps break down the feeling.
3T's have a great self-help library for stress, but for pile of other mental health related topics, right?
Yeah, so we do depression and low mood, there's one about stress, one about anxiety, self-harm, anger, there's loads there. And not only can you download the guides, but there's also videos to go alongside them.
What about changing the situation though? How does that work?
So it's important not to avoid stress, because we can't avoid stress, it's part of everybody's life.
Right.
But things that you can do to help change the situation would be things like maybe avoiding people that stress you out, rather than the situation.
Okay.
Start saying no to people. Start saying, I don't feel comfortable doing that, or that causes me a lot of stress, or even just ask for help with things that do stress you out so you're not taking it all on yourself. It's one way of changing the situation. Mm-hmm. You can also try and gain control over your environment, so try and pick and choose the things that you like doing, you know, or things that you're good at, rather than picking up all the slack.
A very extreme reaction to stress would be suicide.
Yeah, it could be. Like all mental health issues, suicide could be a possibility. It could be one way that somebody chooses to deal with it. So it's important to change your reaction to stress, to be aware that yes, it's something that does happen in all of our lives, but that sometimes we just have to adapt to these things.
Okay.
But suicide isn't always there when somebody is stressed out. But if you're ever concerned, of course, remember, know the signs, know the words, and know your supports.
And with being concerned and with finding those signs, as we said already, the 3T's website has this great self-help library.
Yep.
All the information from today's video are all available along with the self-help library up on www.3ts.ie. Please make sure to subscribe and stay tuned for the final tea time, which will be next week. And if you would like to win one of these fabulous tea time mugs, hold it up, come on, give it a display, give it a rub. If you would like to win one, make sure you tag a person you love in the comments, give them a hug in a mug. They could win one, you could win one, you could both win one. It's all very exciting. Chloe is currently looking for the squeaky toy behind you. The mystery continues. Tune in next week to find out if Chloe ever found the squeaky toy. Bye. Cheers.